my bucket list. I try to keep it short and sweet and open-ended so my adventures never end. But there's always been one place I've wanted to visit since the first YouTube video I ever watched on backpacking. And that place is Pictured Rocks. Welcome to Backpacking with Buckley.
Hello everyone, back on trail. Today I am in the great state of Michigan on what is one of my most anticipated trails ever, Pictured Rocks National Lakeshore, and I am pleasured to be guided by Jason Outdoors, the one and only Jason Outdoors.
We'll get you lost.
So yeah, I have a hard time getting warmed up on video, so I'm going to keep this short. We're hitting the Eastern Terminus. It's on the North Country Trail, but the Pictured Rocks National Lakeshore, doing a 42-mile through hike from here to Munising, Michigan. So we're going to hit the trail, and when I think of something witty to say, I'll check in with you again.
Out, baby. 'Cause I'm begging.
So what you're looking at here is a log flume or slide. This is how they used to get lumber down to the lake back in the day. They have this on the North Shore as well. But one thing I've noticed that really pleases me is the color of the water on the South Shore is a lot more oceanic, turquoise, really beautiful. So I'm glad I came to the South Shore to check it out.
I'm finding hard to hold my own. Just can't make it all alone. I'm holding on, I can't pull back. I'm just a call not to fade to black.
All right, so we are at a outdoor picnic area right by that log slide. But the reason I'm filming this little clip is Jason has some interesting MRE things. We'll get his review in a bit maybe, but look at that ready to eat slice of pizza. Looks straight out of a Italian pizzeria, doesn't it?
Got a bite of his pizza in. What do you think?
That's my Italian.
Is it good? Is it edible?
It's all right.
We got it. It's all right.
At home, no. On trail, everything is good.
Beautiful. So we've been searching for this Amy all day, and it says she's here, but that's total bullshit.
I don't care.
No. Amy! So here they have numbered sites within each site. This is, how do you pronounce this? Aus-Sable?
Aus-Sable.
Aus-Sable.
Like awesome.
So within each individual site, they have these numbered sites. Jason is in number one, strategically placed where he can get eaten before I am tonight. And he's looking at the permit to see where I'm at.
You're number two.
I'm number two.
Yep.
Story of my life. We're gonna go check out this lighthouse down the way, which who doesn't want to check out a lighthouse, right? And as we're filming here, I'm trying to decide how to develop this video into any type of a story. So your guess is as good as mine at this point. But a story always develops on the trail. And with this goofball behind me, I'm guessing something will pop up.
Woo!
Stabilization.
But out in here, Jason's telling me that there's some shipwrecks out here, which would be really cool to see. And here, obviously, is the lighthouse. But what I find most interesting is this has been on my bucket list for a long time, so I've watched countless YouTube videos on pictured rocks. And it's just super exciting that I'm actually here. And this is probably the first landmark I recognize from videos. So it's just a surreal experience to be someplace this cool that you've watched other people walk through 100 times.
What's this guy?
Alright, so our new friend Michael, who we met at camp, has shown us where the shipwreck is up here. So I don't want to put him on the spot and make him dance for us or anything, but he's a great guy we met, enjoying the sunset together. His wife's relaxing at camp. Tara, who's also awesome, reiterates my point that you never meet bad people on trail. Hopefully you can hear the audio over the waves, but we're going to go check out this shipwreck and I'll show you what I can. So this right here is part of the shipwreck, and kind of lackluster, but Jason said it best. Now we can say we saw a shipwreck. So I'm guessing this vessel was beached at some point. I'll get you a little close up.
After a long night of sunsets and chats with new friends around the campfire, we decided to retreat early, as we knew morning would bring rain. Good morning, everybody. Morning of day two. Let's get wet.
Rain is letting up a little bit. Hopefully we'll catch a break. This location is where those shipwrecks are, down the beach of about 1,500 feet. Showed them to you yesterday. But we're gonna mosey on down the trail. See what kind of shenanigans we can get in today.
All right, here's another notable landmark, the Hurricane River.
Sponsored by Dude Wipes. Your bud's best friend.
Here we are at a little picnic area along the trail. Stopped here to do a little loin cleaning and just have some snacks. Beautiful fern forests. Flat trail so far today. We're doing about 13 miles. And it's a nice change of pace from the Black Hills where my muscles were killing me because it's nice flat hiking, beautiful. And even the sun's coming out a little bit. So day's going well so far. Starting to dry out from the dampness of this morning, and we're going to head back down the trail here in a minute and probably be to camp pretty early tonight, believe it or not.
Tell me that I'll never be set free, but I'm parasite. Creep and crawl, I step into the night. 2 pints of booze. Are you a bad fish too? Are you a bad fish too?
I'm kind of ashamed to admit that I'm like maybe the most excited about what we're about to come across, but this is just like quintessential pictured rocks in my head because I see this in every video, and super excited. I'm getting closer as we speak. We're gonna do some photo ops and some real cliche stuff, but this is something I've seen in 1,000 videos and I'm super excited to show you, even though maybe you've seen it 1,000 times, but just a badass little landmark that doesn't make much sense. The famous pictured rocks
old car that I don't know the make or model of.
I hope the night will never end. Lord knows I'm weak. Won't somebody get me off of this reef?
11 miles in for the day. It's been a pretty pleasant flat hike. This is the beach for Trapper's Lake campsite, which is up that direction, and I'm not gonna show you, but Jason stayed there before, so that's pretty sweet. Tom from Walker's World. I forgot to throw you a shout out, Tom. I bought your little Z-Pax thing for my keys, and great advice, I appreciate it, sir. Pine Bluff, Beaver Lake Campgrounds. Getting closer to our spot by the minute. All right, we're at Beaver Creek Camp, all set up. Jason has not disappointed. Well, his personality is a little disappointing, but now we're getting along awesome together. Good hiking partners. And he was the correct tour guide to choose because epic campsite number two for the week. And I will show you guys our views a little later. We're gonna go get some water and we can see the beach from about 100 feet over there. Awesome spot. There is a trouble bear though, so hopefully I can provide you guys with some bloody action later. All right, cruising down some sand dunes and some stairs from our campsite. And this is what our campsite is named for. Creek that runs into Lake Superior called Beaver Creek. Let me take a few more steps and I'll show it to you. So how cool is that? So Jason's got an interesting sandwich here. What is it?
These are from Bridgeford. They're shelf-stable Italian-style sandwiches. I'm sure it's going
to
be
Hold great. That up close to the camera for me. It doesn't look horrible.
We'll find out.
Yeah. So Jason gave me a tiny little bite of this, and he described it perfectly. It's like a cold, sloppy Joe. And you probably know or have an idea how picky I am. That's tasty as hell, isn't it? Or do you disagree? He agrees.
No, that's good. Can I find something you like now?
He found something I like. I'd give that a 5 out of 5 for real. MRE, man. Who'd have thought? Jason's showing off these lines in here. They're all rocks popping out, different sediment layers. And man, this place is an absolute paradise on so many levels. Rock hunters dream too. They search for agates up here a lot, if you're familiar with that. And this is Beaver Creek, which winds its way through the sand to Lake Superior. Jason said that it switches a little bit every year, I suppose because of the winds, but holy crap, this is awesome.
It's definitely got some current.
Gonna get swept to Lake Superior.
Taken away to the dark side. I don't wanna be your left-hand man. I love you when you're singing that song. I got a lump in my throat, cause you gotta sing the words.
Supper time here at camp. Jason's cooking up his famous ramen Velveeta tuna casserole dish. And I'm starting off dinner with one of my favorite protein bursts, which is squirting some of this into my mouth. Here's the new ultralight wind breaker for your stove. It's called Palms. What else do you use your palms for, Jason?
Clapping at golf outings.
Oh, witty response. Hey, Backpacker Bob. You ever snort one of these?
This guy decides to quit his job and heads to New York City. This cowboy's running from himself. And she's been living on the highest shelf. Oh.
Good morning, everybody. It's the morning of day 3. Not sure if you'll be able to hear me, so let's keep it short. It's gonna be a windy one. Look, guys, it's Backpacking with Jason. Oh, no. So today we're doing another 13 miles, and we're going to get some of the more picturesque or quintessential pictured rocks, cliffs and Chapel Rock, all the cool stuff I've seen on videos. Hopefully we get some cool shots regardless of the weather, so we're going to keep moving down trail here, 13 miles to camp today. Earlier you saw us show off Spray Falls, famous landmark. This is a river that leads to it. Yeah, that's about it. Spectacular. Oh, here, I can tell you the name of the river. Oh, Spray Falls. Jason's got the signs memorized, like Beaver Basin Wilderness. He was correct. It, isn't it? Oh, hell yeah. Hell yeah. Oh. All right, we're gonna take a little spur trail to something called Lover's Leap. Another lovely little water source here, the Mosquito River. Huh? All right, we made it to camp for the night, 13 miles in, heading to Potato Patch campsite. Camp, we're all set up. Now we're just doing a little exploring, gonna go try and find some water. Stumbled across this sandstone wall that we had to check out. It's pretty badass. Yeah, it is. So we're gonna find some water and probably think about supper. And whoa. I'm gonna get my face out of here. where we're gonna attempt to get water. Might be interesting. Big success. So I don't know if you can tell, you'll probably be able to tell by the footage today that's windy. But we're just huddled around the beer box for a windbreak trying to get some food, and then we'll probably have a little alone time in our tents and hammock so we can watch a movie or whatever, and then we'll come back to supper later. But it is so windy that there's not going to be a whole lot of action tonight in terms of scenery or things to show you unless a bear comes through these woods. We had a little dinner. We got some unexpected guests in camp. Not that that was bad, but we think we had all three campsites reserved. But we're going to be nice guys and not make a big deal out of it. On the flip side, these folks aren't very social, so we're just hanging out in our campsite. Going to chill out here on this windy-ass ridge and probably go to bed real early. So maybe I'll tell you goodnight later, maybe I won't. Otherwise, see you in the morning, everybody.
So good morning, morning of day four, hiking out of Potato Patch campsite and heading back to the cars, about 9 miles. So trying to be quiet because other people are sleeping, but we made it out of camp early this morning. So we'll check in with you when we get to some of the landmarks along the way.
Pretty, pretty. So what you're looking at here is the only probably significant hill on the entire 42 miles. And it's not too bad. But it's kicking my ass on the last morning with nutrient deficiencies. We keep talking about Hardee's, it's killing me. We just climaxed that hill, and we're heading to Miner's Castle, which is a cool landmark, to have some breakfast.
All right, we're just having like breakfast of luxury here. Look at all that, at the visitor center. And then after that, I'm gonna bring you over there, show you Miner's Castle. And according to Jason, after that, we got about 7 miles of green tunnel. So we're kind of wrapping things up here, but there's still a couple things to come, so we'll show you in a minute.
So we met some trail angels, some park volunteers that filled up our water bottles for us. And we did not accept their gracious generosity, but also even offered to give us money for Hardee's, because Jason and I both left our wallets at the other end of the trailhead. So when we get to his truck, we're gonna be cashless. So delayed gratification on awesome lunch. But as I'm yapping here, walking out to this overlook so I can show you Miner's Castle.
Oh, you're good. And that is Miner's Castle. All right, Buckley brag time. I'm gonna show you the walk we took. We started up at the Grand Sable Visitor Center and have walked almost, well, we're gonna be 42 miles total, all the way down the entire lakeshore to where we're at right now, which is Miner's Castle. Thank you, Jason. And we will end, thanks, Vanna, at Munising Falls Visitor Center, where we started. We got, what, 7 miles?
About 10 inches left.
About 10 inches left. So, yeah, Picture Rocks National Lakeshore. I'll have a lot more to say about this soon, but absolutely phenomenal place.
So aside from Jason Outdoors' video being one of the first of Pictured Rocks that I watched, the first ever YouTube video I watched on backpacking was from Adventure Archives. And I remember from this trail that these plants called doll's eyes. So I've been seeing all along trail, and I think of all the Adventure Archives boys every time I see them. Doll's eyes, I have no idea what they're for, but they're cool. So
the hike is nearing a close. Jason told me we are on the final descent into the parking lot. And once we get there, we got one last thing to show you, and I will tell you goodbye there. So it's been a great 42 miles on Pictured Rocks National Lakeshore with a fantastic hiking partner, a future friend. I'll ask him probably just before we leave if we're gonna have like a second, you don't wanna call it a date because we're both married, but if we're gonna have a second outing together, if he wants to come over and play again. We made it.
We did it.
All right, so what you just saw was Munising Falls. This entire video, I've been calling it Munising, even though Jason's corrected me several times, so I just don't learn very quickly. Anyway, that concludes our journey. Make sure you guys check out Jason Outdoors. I'll put a link down below to his channel because he's got some great content as well. He actually took a break from filming on this trip, so you're just going to have to enjoy mine. But without further ado, let's conclude. Be yourself. Be happy. See you on the next adventure, everybody.
Oh, and one last thing. Two last things. There were small things I didn't get on this trip. One was Hardee's because I couldn't find one. And two was to get to see a bear. So I found the next best solution.